Mr. President, Madam Vice President, you've assumed leadership of this country at a time of great crisis. I am confident that you will be successful in addressing the pandemic and restoring economic growth. But I speak to you today not about the pandemic, but about the opportunities that await this nation after. In particular, the opportunities provided by space exploration to help fuel economic recovery and unite the nation. My organization, the Planetary Society, is the world's largest independent space interest organization. We represent individuals from around the world who are united in their belief that exploring space brings out the best in us. On behalf of our members, I'd like to make the following five recommendations to your administration. Here we go. Number one, deepen our commitment to NASA's science programs. Number two, continue human spaceflight on the path to the moon and Mars. Number three, take active steps to protect the planet from dangerous asteroids and comets. Number four, use NASA as a tool to grow our economy, enhance our manufacturing base, nurture our skilled workforce, and strengthen international alliances. And number five, the 5 over 5 plan, a 5% annual increase to the NASA budget over the next 5 years. These recommendations are ambitious, but they're also affordable and practical. We prepared a paper outlining these in more detail. Anyone can read them online on our website. Now, Mr. President, I understand that you've placed a moon rock on display in the Oval Office. That rock was collected after one of the most ambitious efforts ever undertaken in human history, the Apollo program. By the end of the decade, I believe we could see humans return to the moon. We could see a fleet of spacecraft exploring our nearby worlds, searching for life and peering deeper into the cosmos than ever before. We could better understand the Earth's climate in context with comparable planetary systems and our own solar system and beyond. But those are all conditional. They will depend on your support and the support of Congress. I firmly believe that the scientific exploration of space brings out the best in us. Its inherent difficulty requires cooperation. It unites us. There is no Republican or Democratic ideology when it comes to space exploration. You stand at the cusp of the most exciting decade in space since Apollo. Just think, your gift to the future could be a Mars rock, collected by men and women of this generation, sitting in the Oval Office of a future president. On behalf of the Planetary Society, Mr. President, Madam Vice President, I urge you both to embrace the opportunity that is NASA. Space exploration is not something that's done out there. It's done here for all of us, in our nation and on Earth. Thank you.